very good evening to you. Thank you for joining us. Welcome to Sports Tonight. This is the fourth edition of Sports Tonight for the week. Promises to be exciting, fun-filled, as always. I'd like to start by saying a very big thank you to you for joining us, and also tell you that it's a privilege to be back on the show. And I hope that together, for the next 50 minutes, we will make it very enjoyable, as always. I mean, what you always get on Sports Tonight. So thank you once again for joining in. And together, for the next 50 minutes, we'll be taking you on a trip around the exciting world of sports. And this is one trip that will take us around the country. We will, of course, take you to Sudan, talk about the IWTF African T16, African Top 16 Championship currently going on for table tennis. Good news coming through for Nigeria from Sudan. We will also, on the program tonight, be taking you to Calabar, the Cross River State Capital, essentially to talk about the National Sports Festival. On the program tonight, we will also be focusing on Nigerian clubs. Over the weekend, all four were involved in the CAF Continental Club competition. It was good because we had three victories and one loss. Good start, if you want to say, but then there's still plenty of work for us to do in terms of our team and their search for continental success this season. Of course, we will be taking you to Abuja. The Nigerian Football Federation Executive Committee will be meeting tomorrow in Abuja. We will try to talk about it and try to also speak about some of the things that we expect that they will be doing at their meeting tomorrow in Abuja. Of course, it's a Monday, and usually on Mondays, we like to give you some reviews of games on the domestic scene. But there are no games now because the season is still on break. But then, the 2015-2016 Nigeria Professional Football League season is starting this weekend. So we will start a preview for you on the program tonight. We'll be talking about some of the clubs. We'll be talking about some of the transfers that you've seen on the domestic scene, and try to whet your appetite ahead of the resumption of the Nigeria Professional Football League season. Of course, tomorrow and on Wednesday, focus will shift to UEFA Champions League, big games lined up across Europe. We'll talk about all of that as well on the program this Monday. We won't forget, of course, to talk about the big one that will be happening in a couple of days, less than 2 weeks from now. The World Soccer Governing Body, FIFA, will be having a new president. And, of course, the reactions, the preparations, the gladiators are talking tough. And we're looking forward to it. And we'll be doing a lot of that on the program tonight as well. FIFA president, suspended FIFA president, Blatter. And, of course, suspended UEFA president, Michel Platini, look like they have a final chance to clear their name. And we'll be talking about that as we go along on the program tonight. So that's going to be the setting for the show tonight. Looks like I have a lot of catching up to do, but I'm sure we're going to be making it as fun as possible on the program tonight as we go along. But let's start off the show the way we always start it, and of course the way my guys have been doing it while I was away, keeping the tempo very high. And that's by way of feedback, and tell you that you, as always, will be very, very key to all that we'll be doing on Sports Tonight this Monday. And that's because we want you to get involved with us via feedback. And you already know the platforms already. We can give us your own opinion to some of these issues that I've highlighted for you on the program using all that you're seeing right there on your screen. And tonight will not be any different. We will try to give time to your feedback on Facebook, and of course on Twitter. We will try to read your thoughts as you send them across to us from all across the globe. But you need to also understand that you can track all that we're doing on Channel CV, all the news, all the stories. Of course, you can track them on channelstv.com. It's as simple as that. On youtube.com/channelsweb. You can follow up on all that is going on Channels TV. And if you want to watch on your device, whether it's iPad or iPhone or BlackBerry, all you need to do is click on m.channelstv.com and you'll be on to your home for the news. And it gets better if you go one step further and download the Channels app for Android, for iOS, for Windows, from their respective stores, you will be able to download and follow real time all that's going on Channels TV. Don't forget, as you do all of that, just include in your feedback where you're watching us from as you send your message across to us so that we can broadcast the same to all those who are watching us on all platforms, terrestrial, online, I mean, wherever you're watching us from on your award-winning Channels television. All right, so that's how we start off the show tonight. But let's start off with some very, very good news coming through. We want to start off with table tennis, one of the most high-profile rivalries you will find in table tennis, particularly in Africa, has got to be the rivalry between Egypt's Omar Asar and Nigeria's Haruna Quadri. But the good news for us coming out of the ongoing IWTF African Top 16 Cup in Sudan is that Nigeria's Haruna Quadri has scored one, a big one, over Omar Asar. Haruna Quadri beat Omar Asar by 4-1 today to win the IWTF African Top 16 Championship in Sudan. So that's some fantastic news coming through for us, and gladdens us, gladdens our hearts, because for a very, very long time, Omar Asar has had the edge over Haruna Quadri. But this is encouraging for us. Haruna Quadri defeating his Egyptian rival, Omar Asar, 4-1. That's a convincing win for the Nigerian, and we hope that he carries this one forward, because this is not the end. It's just a good start for Haruna Quadri. He needs to go on to the Olympic Games qualifiers now, starting tomorrow, and they go on to replicate this form and go out there and do Nigeria proud. Segun Toriola is also involved, and a whole lot of other Nigerian table tennis players, men and women, are also involved in this one. But that's the good news coming through for Nigeria. The victory of Haruna Quadri over Omar Asar. Don't forget, Omar Asar is the best ranked African table tennis player. Segun Haruna Quadri is the second best, and this victory, I'm sure, will go a long way in helping Haruna Quadri to improve his rankings. He's currently ranked 37th in the world, and that's a good one for him. But we hope he can keep getting higher and higher. So that's some good news for us coming through from table tennis, and that's a fantastic way for us to start the week, and of course for us to start sports tonight, this Monday. From Sudan,